extremely happy to be here because I think it's immediately after this particular inaugural function, we have a discussion on biodiversity, the anniversary of the National Biodiversity Authority under Dr. Gautam. These are related because some years ago, what was called the Chiang Mai Declaration of the World Health Organization, the slogan was save plants to save lives, save plants to save lives. Nature, tomorrow is the International Day of Non-Violence in honor of Mahatma Gandhi's birthday. And Gandhiji always used to say, nature provides for everyone's needs, but not for everyone's greed. You find everything. If you go to the coastal area, the halophytes, there are xerophytes, all kinds of plants and animals to suit different needs. But many of them lie undiscovered. And this is where we are indebted to Professor p.i.peter for bringing to light the multiple benefits that Noni confers in relation to human wellness. Because sometimes things can remain as blossoms in the dust, human beings also, if you don't care for them. Similarly, the plants can lie. He has made it to the modern Indian ginseng, and it's a remarkable achievement within a short period of time of Professor Peter, which I greatly admire. We are happy that we have got such eminent scientists like Dr. Scott Nelson from Hawaii and Dr. Myoing Wong from University of Illinois and Dr. Jorge Pino from Cuba and from Sri Lanka, United States, Canada, and many other, Bangladesh and many other places. I think this kind of international interaction is very beneficial because in science we find we can save time, we can learn from each other, what we call purchase time. We can purchase time, we not rediscover the wheel, understand from somebody else and what has been done. And this is why I'm happy that this first world Noni Congress is being held, and also Dr. Kirti Singh announced once in 5 years hereafter you will have a World Noni Congress. That is the fastest way of accelerating the pace of scientific advances. And hence again, I congratulate you, Professor Peter, and all your colleagues for what you have done. I also want to congratulate both Dr. Subramani and Dr. Gangadhar Satpathy for their outstanding work, which was recognized today. We are grateful to you for what you are doing. When Professor Peter mentioned to me, I have known him for the last, ever since I came to Chennai in 1989, he has been a remarkable person. And he told me that when he started his work in Noni, the first thing he is going to do is to start the Noni Research Foundation. In other words, there are many times we go by empirical observations, particularly this is true in some of the herbal medicine and so on. Not that age and experience are important, but empirical evidence has to be converted into scientific evidence. This is what the Noni Research Foundation is doing, to have the scientific validation of many of our observations. I congratulate you again, because some of our own indigenous systems of medicine, not only ours but also internationally, there is a feeling that there is need for more scientific validation of what we are saying. These are all the benefits of the crop and so on. Here again, as is clear from this first World Noni Congress and also the World Science Foundation. And Dr. Peter himself is chairing the Noni Biotech. What I find in this large audience, over 1,000 people are here, you have all the stakeholders. You have the scientists, you have the growers, cultivators, you have the processors, you have those who are spreading the message of Noni. Information and also sales and so on. It's a very good thing again to have all of you together in the different billings in the Noni chain, from production to consumption and use. And I again congratulate the structure of this Congress. It's a very beneficial from the point of view of speedy interaction among various people, the knowledge gatherers, the knowledge appliers, and the knowledge users. All of them are here. Another reason why I believe that in our country, in India particularly, where we have many problems, not only health, but undernutrition, malnutrition, many times arising from not so much the lack of food in the market, but lack of purchasing power. We require more jobs, more skilled jobs, more income to the growers. In fact, the national policy for farmers, announced by the Government of India 3 years ago, calls for a paradigm shift from purely yield to income to the farmers. And this means value addition to primary products, processing, understanding. Plants like Noni are a good example. You are trying to create value-added material from there, a wide variety of products. And we hope that more and more plants of this kind will receive the same attention as Noni. The other point I admire in this Noni movement is the emphasis on integrated pest management and more ecological agriculture, cultivation of plants which based upon ecological principles or which are sound from the point of view of the environment. Because many times medicinal plants are grown in a way which, unfortunately, the application of pesticides and so on gets into the residue problem, there are many other problems. And this is why we have always, the National Commission on Farmers, we recommended that all medicinal plants should only be cultivated by organic farming methods and not by use of chemicals, because then it sort of hides the value of that particular element. So I am glad that you have got here. In fact, our the people who are honored were those who have done a lot of work on control of management of pests. We call it management, integrated pest management. Not so much control, but how to manage the pest is important. The other important achievement being recorded here is the use of micropropagation, tissue culture, multiplying elite plants, because many times there are plants of particular value and they will have to be multiplied and propagated. And so right from the beginning, Noni Research Foundation has fostered. This is why Professor Peter himself is chairman of the Noni Biotech, as he called. Biotechnology is a broad field. There is micropropagation is one of the important ones, tissue culture propagation, cell culture, and so on. There are some other aspects of biotechnology, like genetic modification, recombinant DNA technology, which have created both pros and cons. In other words, there are people who would like to see that we don't genetically modify crops. The recent example of BT brinjal, the eggplant, is a good example. Here again, what we require is a regulatory mechanism. I was very happy to meet this morning a lady who introduced herself, I think working with Professor Peter, as a food safety person. I am very happy because I think food safety, the adoption of the Codex Alimentarius standards of food safety, these are exceedingly important. They are not known. If you go to a village and ask what is Codex Alimentarius, farmers won't know unless you teach them what is food safety and the hygiene. And today morning I received some papers about the amount of aflatoxins in some of the varieties of rice which are moist, which have been kept under a moist storage. You have a problem of aflatoxin. So I congratulate you again, Dr. Peter, that you have given a lot of emphasis on food safety and also the material which is. But let me say a word about biotechnology. Government of India today is developing a national biotechnology regulatory system. I call it a system because the biotechnology regulatory authority has to have many dimensions: the environmental dimension, the human food safety dimension, and the entire process of what is going to be the long-term impact on biodiversity in particular. There are many aspects of biotechnology regulatory authority. This is why the Government of India is trying to bring an act before Parliament of a bill, Biotechnology Regulatory System Bill, which will provide for a regulatory authority which has all the expertise. If you go to the United States, there is the Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, there is the APHIS, Agricultural Plant Health Inspection Service. Then there is FDA, the Federal Drug Administration. In every case, all the three, the FDA, EPA, and FS, they look at the problem in all its dimension. We have to have a mechanism by which we have a regulatory mechanism which inspires public confidence, political confidence, professional confidence, and above all, media confidence, because media is a very important method of carrying the news to the public. So I want to thank Dr. Peter for taking up the biotechnology research in a serious way in which it can confer benefits to everybody. Ladies and gentlemen, I think we are already fine. We are behind the time which has been announced. May I hope to all the members of the Noni family here, I think you should take the benefits of Noni to far and wide, particularly to those who will benefit even more, because there are many plants, as I said earlier. Dr. Pushpangadhan, who was mentioned, identified a plant with the Kani tribe, which is called Arogya Pacha, which also gives you a fatigue. It reduces the fatigue of a person. Noni also has that kind of energy-enhancing character. Many of these plants with which we are gifted in our country ought to be, and many of them are in tribal areas, in people where they have indigenous knowledge. Since our chief guest here, General Pupitna Singh, is here, I must tell you, sir, when after the tsunami of January 26, 2004, the Prime Minister had been to Andamans, and then he said, we must have a post-tsunami New Andamans. And we were asked from our foundation to help in preparing a report. It is titled Post-Tsunami New Andamans. One of the things our group of people who went there under the leadership of Professor Keshavan discovered, enormous amount of wisdom of the local